Now to a decision that could change the way doctors and insurance companies treat and cover obese patients. For the first time in its history, the American Medical Association has voted to officially classify obesity as a disease. Dr. Nancy Snyderman is NBC's chief medical editor. She joins us now. This is not without controversy, but is this a big deal, how obesity is labeled by the AMA?
It's a big deal. It's been percolating for a while. And if you talk to people who deal with obese patients or diabetes, they've been pushing for this because they really see this as a disease state that then links to things like, you know, high blood pressure, diabetes, and heart disease.
I was going to say there are pros to this, there are cons to this. Let's talk about some of the advantages. The first thing I thought of was, well, maybe that means insurers will reimburse more.
Interestingly, that's a pro and a con. But the real pro is prevention, correct diagnosis, and then the extrapolation to other diseases. Can you stop it? That's the big pro.
But the BMI, which is the measure of obesity, is not a perfect measure of good health
and there's
or
one
bad
of the bug
health, right?
That's right. So, look, the BMI is imperfect. That's what they were sort of using. And you mentioned the cons. The cons are it takes away these sort of discipline environmental issues. Does it mean then that people are going to say, well, I don't really have to worry about what I eat, cheap bad food, eat too much? So I think you have two opposing sides, inside of medicine and outside of medicine. Those who say, hey, look, your brain gets rewired with fat, sugar, salt. Genetics play a role, so of course it's a disease. You have the non-disease people saying, wait a minute, how about self-discipline? And those two things come crashing together. But then you have real science where you know the brain gets rewired, people who get gastric banding and gastric bypass see their numbers change, cholesterol, blood sugar, on the table before they even get to the recovery room. Insurers are going to push back. And while this has no legal standing, the AMA has a lot of clout when it comes to policy.
A lot of influence.
And so I think things are going to change.
I was interested in one note in the recommendation. You're essentially labeling one-third of Americans as ill. So we know it's a big deal.
Yep, and two-thirds are overweight or obese.
Dr.
So this is not going away.
Nancy Snyderman, good to see you.
Thank
you so much.